So in my career, I've tried hard. I've worried a lot about not stepping on landmines that would blow me and my business apart. And for the most part, I've avoided them. But let me tell you about one that I didn't. It's 2010, and we're at the height of the social media craze. Old Spice Guy is responding to tweets with YouTube videos in real time, and old and new media is exploding. Everyone's trying to figure out how to do this. At the time, my firm is doing social media work with a fairly large company, and I notice a trend online. There are a group of people complaining on social media, and my client actually has a solution for it. So I research and I test and I validate an idea, and I pitch it to the head of a division that wants to grow and that also wants to get into social media. It's a small idea, but it has big upside for my client, and let's face it, for me and my firm. On the other hand, it's a little bit bold and a little bit risky for my client. But the head of the division goes for it, and he brings in my firm to help run and manage the project. While I'm putting all of this together, I'm also looking for some really good collaborators. And I find this hot New York City interactive firm that has the chops and the balls to do this right. And I adamantly bring them into the client, and they finally agree. Now, usually when I do this, I'll try to do all the sub-vendor contracts under me so I have a little bit more control. But that's not happening. The client and the interactive firm write their contract directly, and it's a poorly written contract for a lot of money. Remember this. At our first meeting with me and my client, the interactive firm, and now the agency of record, the fighting starts. The agency's pissed that someone else is doing the work. The interactive guys feel dissed by the agency. The client does not like the fighting. I'm just trying to get everybody to work together and move forward. Over the next couple of months, things don't get much better. The interactive firm will present some ideas, and they'll overreact to every piece of feedback they get. The agency is still pissed they're not doing the work. The client, meanwhile, is so busy on other stuff that they seem to have forgotten everything that's happened up to now. Progress is excruciating, and I'm just trying to pull everything out of the muck. I'm the one right now who's losing sleep over this. You know, this is my baby, and I feel all of the responsibility with none of the authority. I'm just trying to keep this thing, bring this thing forward without having it just blow up. Which, of course, it does. One day, the interactive firm announces that it's burned through all of its substantial cash without leaving one thing that we can actually use. Remember that contract? The client agreed to pay everything up front, so they had no hold over the vendor. After months of work and hundreds of thousands of dollars spent, this thing is a dead disaster. And I'm waiting for that landmine to explode right under my feet. I'm waiting for the screaming and recriminations and threats to my business. I feel like I kind of deserve it. And you know what happens? Nothing. Nothing. Everyone moves on. Within a month, I'm doing other social media work for another group in the company. And at the end of the day, this is something that didn't mean much to anyone. While this is going on, my mom discovers she has a brain tumor. And within 2 years, it's going to kill her. She lived a good long life, 87 years. But she would always call me during work, want to chat and talk. And I'd always cut her off. I had landmines to avoid and failures to worry about. You know, she was trying to give me a message that time was running out. And I kept failing her. You know what I'd give to have a talk with my mom right now? I was worried about stuff that didn't matter. You know, when we think of failure, we think it has to be big and dramatic and lead to aha moments. But I don't think that's true. I just think we notice them more while they distract us from those small, everyday failures that really hurt. And so what I've learned is to pay attention to the small failures, the ones that matter to the people that I love. And while I continue to fail, I'm just trying to fail a little less before it's too late for me. Thank you. Thank you.